Hi students, welcome back to my channel. In my last video I explained about aldol condensation and its mechanism. Now I am coming with this video to explain cross aldol condensation. Cross aldol condensation is the reaction in which two different aldehydes are two different ketones are an aldehyde and a ketone containing alpha hydrogen. When condensed together, we will get a product of alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. Let me give you a recap on mechanism of aldol condensation. An aldehyde containing alpha hydrogen loses its alpha hydrogen in presence of basic medium. And will be converted into a carbene ion which acts as a nucleophile. This is the carbonyl carbon atom and this is alpha carbon atom, and hydrogen atoms bonded to alpha carbon are alpha hydrogens. So this aldehyde is losing that alpha hydrogen because it is acidic. It will be absorbed by hydroxyl ion and we will get carbene ion. This carbene ion attacks on another aldehyde, nucleophilic attack on carbonyl carbon atom takes place, and a new bonding between this alpha carbon atom of aldehyde and carbonyl carbon atom of another aldehyde molecule. And you will get a reaction intermediate which absorbs H plus ion from water, which is a solvent, and will be converted into aldol. When this aldol is heated, it loses water molecule and will be converted into alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. When we observe this mechanism, one of the aldehyde is being converted into carbene ion and I call this another aldehyde as target aldehyde. So in aldol condensation, out of the two aldehyde molecules, one acts as carbene ion, another one remains as target aldehyde. Let us apply this mechanism to cross aldol condensation. For that I need to take two different aldehydes. I have taken 1 mole of ethanol and 1 mole propanol, and I need to divide them into target aldehyde and aldehyde which can become carbene ion or nucleophile. I have four possibilities. As I have taken one mole of ethanol, some part of it acts as target aldehyde. Remaining part of same ethanol can become carbanion. And from this one mole of propanol, some part of it acts as target aldehyde. Remaining part of propanol can form carbanion. Now, ethanol acts as target aldehyde and propanol can form carbanion. And another possibility is propanol can become target aldehyde and ethanol can form carbanion. And what we have observed from reaction mechanism is these aldehydes loses their alpha hydrogen to become carbanion. This is the functional group and this is the carbon atom. So it loses its alpha hydrogen to give a carbanion of CH2CHO. And when you come to second possibility, this is alpha carbon. It loses its alpha hydrogen to become a carbanion like this. And when you come to the third possibility, this is also propanol, so you will get the same carbanion. And when you come to this is alpha carbon. If it loses its alpha hydrogen, the carbanion that we will get is this one. And this carbanion attacks on carbonyl carbon of target aldehyde. So this nucleophilic carbon atom attacks on this carbonyl carbon. Now what is the product you will get? You see, CH3CH, and from the reaction mechanism we have observed that this aldehyde group, oxygen atom of aldehyde group, will become OH group. And a new bond will be formed between this alpha carbon of carbanion and carbonyl carbon of target aldehyde. So you will get a bonding between CH and this CH2 group. So this is the aldol that we get in this reaction. And when it is heated, H2O will be removed. This OH group and this hydrogen will be removed. And you will get the product of condensation. And if you follow the same procedure for the remaining combinations also, you will get a bonding between this nucleophilic carbon atom and this carbonyl carbon. So the product can be like this. And for the third combination, this nucleophilic carbon can attack on carbonyl carbon of this aldehyde. when it is heated, it loses water. And the final product is this. And finally, this nucleophilic center of carbon ion, when attacks on carbonyl carbon of target aldehyde, the product will be like this. When it is heated, loses water molecule. And this will be the final product. Now let us see a few tricks to identify from which reactant molecules these aldol condensation products are formed. This 4-hydroxy-4-methyl-pentane-2-one is a beta hydroxy carbonyl compound. And to find out from which aldehyde and ketone this product is formed, you just see where the carbonyl group is present. This is the carbonyl group we have. The carbon atom next to carbonyl group is alpha carbon. And we already know that we will get a new bond between alpha carbon of one aldehyde or ketone and carbonyl group of another aldehyde or ketone. So you just break this bond and add one hydrogen to this alpha carbon. So you will get one of the reactant molecule. The second part is you convert this alcohol group into carbonyl group. It means this product is formed from two propanone molecules. And when we come to alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, you see the double bond and break this double bond and observe where do you have alpha carbon. This is the functional group and this is the alpha carbon atom. After breaking this double bond, add 2 hydrogen atoms to that double bonded carbon, alpha carbon atom, and oxygen atom to the remaining part of the group. So what are the products we got? It means this 2-methyl-pent-2-enol molecule is the aldol condensation product of two molecules of propanol. I hope this video is helpful to understand aldol condensation. Thank you.